Hi, my name is Jennifer Simeone from Waters Corporation. Today I'm going to talk to you about my poster entitled Development of a High Sensitivity UPLC MSMS Method for the Analysis of Clopidogrel and its Carboxylic Acid Metabolite in Human Plasma. So as a quick introduction, clopidogrel, better known by its trade name of Plavix, is often prescribed to prevent blood clots for people with certain heart or blood vessel conditions. It's dosed in its inactive prodrug form, and it requires a transformation to its active metabolite. It also produces an inactive metabolite, which you see here. It's the carboxylic acid metabolite. Because the active metabolite is so reactive and hard to test for in blood, we developed a method testing for the prodrug and its inactive metabolite. So the methodology utilizes a microelution SPE sample preparation technique. It's then injected onto an Acuity I-class system, which is attached to a Zevo TQS tandem quadruple mass spec. Also, Unify software was used for the processing of all results. So most of the current methods for clopidogrel utilize a liquid-liquid extraction. And so this is not only time-consuming, but it also uses large quantities of hazardous solvents, typically on the order of 2 to 8 mL per sample. In contrast, the microelution SPE method that we developed uses only 0.5 mL of organic solvent per sample. In addition, it doesn't require a dry down and reconstitution step, so it's also much quicker and can improve your productivity. So this chromatogram is just showing the resulting peaks for both the clopidogrel and its inactive metabolite, as well as the deuterated internal standard for each. Clopidogrel elutes at 2.8 minutes, while the metabolite elutes at 1.7 minutes. The calibration range was 1 to 500 picograms per mil, and this was linear, using a 1 over x linear regression with an R-squared value of 0.9999, which is very good. So another important aspect of any bioanalytical method is to assess for carryover. So if you have a high concentration sample, you don't want it carrying over into your next one because it'll give you incorrect results. So the way that you test for this is you inject your highest calibration standard, and then immediately following that you inject a blank sample, which should have none of your analyte in it, theoretically, unless it's being carried over. So in this figure you can see that for both clopidogrel and its metabolite, this is the high standard, and then below we have the blank injection following it, and you can see that for both they're clean, so this assay shows no carryover, which is great. So in order for a method to be utilized under regulated situations, it has to meet certain criteria, one of which is the carryover. Another one is your lowest standard has to produce a signal to noise of at least 5 to 1. So this figure is showing the signal to noise calculated for both clopidogrel and its metabolite, and you can see that for both the signal to noise is 7 to 1, which meets the criteria. Another aspect of your method is that it should be accurate and precise. And this is also set forth in the FDA guidelines. So what we did here is a typical, it's just a validation batch. It has your QCs prepared at 4 different concentrations, and they're injected in replicates of 5. And so if you look at the method validation guidance, this is how a typical validation batch would look. And you can see from the percent CVs and percent biases produced that this method is indeed accurate and precise, and it would meet all FDA regulations. Another essential part of assay reliability and robustness is the ability to separate your compounds of interest from co-eluting matrix interferences. So these can negatively impact your assay because if it co-eludes, they can compete for ionization, either causing suppression or just general reproducibility issues. Within bioanalytical studies, one of the most common sources of these interferences is the phospholipids that are present in biological samples. So there are two ways to address this. You can either address it in the sample prep portion by using something such as a phospholipid capture plate, or you can address it in the LC by trying to separate your compound from the eluting phospholipids. So an easy way to monitor for these is to do a parent scan of the common 184 M over Z fragment. So what I have shown in figure 6, it's an overlay of the clopidogrel and its metabolite, and in the background is the precursor scan for the 184 M over Z. And you can see that the clopidogrel metabolite elutes much earlier than the phospholipids. The Plavix, on the other hand, is in a region which could be susceptible to matrix interferences, but the LC method was modified so that it actually elutes in between two larger regions of phospholipids. So in this way, we have successfully separated both of the analytes from the phospholipids, which should generate a much more reliable method. In conclusion, a high sensitivity method for both clopidogrel and its inactive acid metabolite has been produced utilizing a microelution SPE sample prep method. The assay was linear over the range of 1 to 500 picograms per mil and showed no detectable carryover for either of the analytes. The statistics for 5 replicates of injections at 4 different concentration levels showed a percent CV and percent bias acceptable by FDA requirements. Both analytes of interest were successfully separated from co-eluting phospholipids. By using UPLC with ZevoTQS within a unified workflow, we have achieved a high sensitivity bioanalytical method. Thank you for your attention.